Hey guys, what's going on? And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to access the files on your Mac from any Android smartphone or tablet. Let's get started. So in this exercise, we're gonna be using the Galaxy Note 4. This will work on any Android device.
Step number one.
The first thing you need to do is head over to the Play Store and download ES File Explorer. ES File Explorer is just another file manager with some extra features, such as adding networks to your file structure.
Step two.
The next thing you want to do is go to google.com and type in, what is my IP? What this will do is it will show you your modem's IP address. Write this down as you will need it for later.
Step three.
Okay, so now you want to go to System Preferences, Sharing, and make sure remote login is checked. You will see right here you have a local IP address. We will be changing this later. You want to also make sure that file sharing is checked and select which folders you do want to share and which users have capabilities to read or write, which basically means who has permission to view and alter the files.
Now your cable or DSL modem has an IP address and your router also has an IP address. The one your router gives out is a local IP address for your in-home network, and your modem is a specific IP address, a much longer one that's designated for your modem.
Now you want to go back into your System Preferences, go to Network, and whichever network you're connected to, I'm connected via Wi-Fi, click that, and then you want to go to where it says Advanced. Once the Advanced window is open, on the bottom you'll see your MAC address to the current connection you have. In this case, this is my MAC address. Write this down also as you will need it for later. And in this tab where it says TCP/IP, you want to click that and make sure where it says configure IPv4, make sure it's under using DHCP. If it's under this one, that means you want to assign your Mac a static local IP address. We don't want to do that. Just click this. Hit OK. Done.
Step 4.
Find out which router you have. I'm currently using a Linksys router, and the login to that is 192.168.1.1. Now, if you don't know your router's login information, most routers by default, the username is admin and the password is admin. Now, if the username and password is not admin, take a look behind your router and it should be on the sticker with the username and password.
Step 5.
Now, if you look below here, you see that this is your IP range. You can choose an IP address with a number in between 100 and 149.
Step number 6.
If you hit DHCP reservation, you see a list of clients currently connected to your home network along with their IP address and MAC address. If you scroll down under add clients, this is where you will need to paste that MAC address that you copied earlier and select a current IP address that is not being used amongst the list. Then click add.
Step 7.
Dig through the menus and find the tab where it says something like applications and gaming or port forwarding. One of those two titles should do the trick.
Now what port forwarding is basically the modem receives an incoming signal from port number 22. It then bounces that signal to your local IP address that you've chosen earlier to link to your MAC address.
Now right here is a bunch of ports that I set up and I've named them so I can always go back to them. So now you see I've mentioned port number 22 deals with SFTP connections. Any incoming connection from port 22, forward it to my local IP address that I've chosen. Once the information is passed to the machine, you just need to verify your username and password from any client application. Our client application in this video is ES File Explorer. Now the final step is the easy one. Open ES File Explorer, hit network, and then you want to hit new. You want to add a new connection. From the list of options they give you, select SFTP connection. In the box where it says server, you want to enter the IP address that you copied down at the beginning of the video from the Google search. Enter it here, /users/ your username for your Mac. It should already be pre-filled with the number 22. Then you enter your username and your password. And that's it. You should be able to see all your files, including your desktop, music, pictures, and all the other good stuff. You would now be able to copy files to and from your Mac, so long your machine is powered on and running. As well as delete files. And you're done.
I would use this for casual use. I wouldn't use it if you have extremely private files. Reason being is because you don't necessarily want to be walking around with your IP address on your phone and your username on your phone. It'll be very easy for someone to get into your browser files if they just knew who you were simply by your username and password. So I wouldn't recommend doing that. Your cable or DSL modem's IP address, that will change periodically. What businesses often do to keep all their computers talking to each other at all times is they will go ahead and purchase a static IP address. Therefore, their modem's address would never change. My modem, however, this connection that I set up, this would change periodically. The reason being is because I'm not running any businesses and it's not that serious to me. I only use it for casual use. I don't have any information that's too sensitive, so I don't want to purchase a static IP address. However, you can feel free to go ahead and do so yourself. Now, you can go ahead and set up this connection also with a static IP address. So in other words, I can assign my Mac within the network settings a static IP address. However, what I've noticed is that over time, the IP address would get shuffled back into the mix and redistributed to another device. So what I found that works is reserving an IP address. Therefore, no other device connected on my network can have that IP address. Only my machine with my Mac address. You're guaranteed to always have that address no matter how long your machine is off. Once this bad boy's up on the network, it's going to have that same local IP address that you've chosen. Just keep in mind, the computer does need to be on. This would not work if your computer is off. You won't be able to access it. So if you're gonna be heading out and you wanna be able to still have access to your files and media, just make sure your computer's on and you're good to go. I hope it helped. Let me know in the comment section if this worked for you. If it did, that's great. If not, leave me a comment and I'll be more than willing to help you out. All right, guys, that wraps it up for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.